Today's PortSwigger tutorial is entitled JSON Web Token Authentication Bypass via Kid Header Path Traversal. To solve the lab, we must access the admin panel and delete the user Carlos. As with the previous labs, we are going to be using Burp's JWT editor extension. If you do not have the extension installed, go to Burp Extensions B App Store and search for JWT editor. Select the extension and click Install to install it. Now access the lab and log in with the provided credentials, Winner Peter. Back in Burp, go to Proxy, HTTP History and look for the Get My Account request. Send this request to Repeater by pressing Ctrl-R. In Repeater, we can see that we are logged in as Winner. Now delete this query parameter, ID equals Winner, and make sure you are still logged in as Winner. Next, go to the JSON Web Token tab. Observe that the signing algorithm is HS256, which is a symmetric keyed hashing algorithm. This means that the server uses the same secret key for both generating the signature and validating it. We also know that the lab's server fetches the key from the file system based on the key ID parameter. Suppose that looks something like this. Because the server is vulnerable to directory traversal, we can use a kid parameter such as ../..././/dev/null. This will traverse up multiple levels in the directory hierarchy, eventually reaching the root directory and accessing the dev null file. Dev null is a special file in Linux that discards all data written to it. Because of this, reading from it will return an empty string. As a result, if the server uses the content of dev null as the key to verify the JSON Web Token signature, it will essentially be signing the token with an empty string as the key. Therefore, signing the token with an empty string will result in a valid signature. To sign the token with an empty string, go to the Attack button at the bottom of the screen and select Sign with Empty Key. The algorithm is HS256. Click OK and send the request. You should still be logged in as Winner, which means that the server has accepted the signature. All that's left to do now is to try logging in as the administrator. Change the value of the subject to administrator and send the request again. We are logged in as the administrator and now have access to the admin panel. Go back to the Raw tab and change the request line to get/admin to navigate to the admin panel. We see a link to delete the user Carlos. Go to the Delete Username Carlos page by adding the path to the request line. We get a 302 found response. If we go back to the admin page, we can see the message "user deleted successfully." Also observe that the Delete Username Carlos path is no more. Back in the browser, we also see that the lab has been solved. This is it for today's tutorial. See you in the next one. Bye!